Yeah. The epistle for the feast for the Sunday after the Ascension is taken from the first epistle of St. Peter. Dearly beloved, be prudent in watch and prayers, but above all things have a constant mutual charity among yourselves, for charity covereth a multitude of sins. Using hospitality one towards another without murmuring, as every man hath received grace, ministering the same one to another, as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. If any man speak, let him speak as the words of God. If any man minister, let him do it as the power which God administereth, that in all things God may be honored through Jesus Christ our Lord. And please stand for the Holy Gospel, which is taken from the Gospel according to St. John. At that time Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Paraclete cometh, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceedeth from the Father, he shall give testimony of me. And you shall give testimony, because you are with me from the beginning. These things I have spoken to you, that you may not be scandalized. They will put you out of the synagogues, ere the hour cometh, that whosoever killeth you will think that he doth a service to God. And these things they will do to you, because they have not known the Father, nor me. But these things I have told you, that when the hour shall come, you may remember that I told you." Thus far the words of today's Holy Gospel. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, amen. Dear faithful, I wish to return to a familiar subject of prayer. It is something which we can always deepen to try to do better. It is the heart of the Christian life, insofar as from prayer we have the grace to do. To do what is our duty to God. So we are now in the time between the Ascension and Pentecost, and it was a time when the apostles did pray. They spent much time in prayer preparing themselves for the Holy Ghost. So it's one of the most important duties of the Christian life to pray. And some Christians neglect it, others not entirely, certainly. They pray frequently, but those the better Christians often pray, but imperfectly. It is hard to pray really as we ought. It can easily be that our prayers, at least at times, are lip service rather than anything else. So St. Peter exhorts us in today's epistle to be prudent and watchful in prayer. So prudence teaches us when to pray, watchfulness to avoid certain defects in our prayers. First, to recall the nature of prayer, it is something simple, the raising of our hearts and our minds to God, as St. John Damascene says, but for certain purposes, to beg for the graces that we need, to thank him for his benefits, to seek his help, to avoid evils. In a word, it's a communing or conversation with God. It can be vocal, which is a good prayer, when our lips recite a set form of words which the Church has approved, the best prayer, the Our Father. But higher than this still is the mental prayer. We pour forth our soul in fervent prayers, in supplication for God's help, for his graces. With our minds we reflect upon God's goodness, his greatness. With our will we resolve to do what is most pleasing to God. There are two important truths which we ought to remember about prayer. First, it's especially important to remember that we are in God's presence when we do pray. We think of the presence of God. Many times we are distracted in our prayers, thinking God is very far from us. But God is very close to those who pray. St. Teresa recommended this practice of the presence of God at the beginning of prayer. She says that is why we are often distracted, because we don't recall how close God is to us when we pray. The second is that prayer is absolutely necessary for salvation. We must pray, we need to pray. Well, to enter heaven, we have to obey the commandments. But how can we pray the prayer? How can we keep the commandments if we do not have the grace to do so? And so, if we are to be supported in our battle against our three enemies, we must pray. And you know the three enemies, the flesh, the world, the devil, that our bodies flee pain. We flee mortification. We desire too much pleasures. The world, or as our enemy, is the example of others who are not leading a good life. If they are breaking God's commandments and seeming to be very happy, we have a bad example before us, and we might be tempted to cast away the cross and to follow them. And the devil, well, our most cunning enemy, he has centuries of experience in tempting souls. So against these three great enemies, we see our poor weak selves. And so it's but natural that we turn to prayer. As St. Paul says, pray without ceasing. And Christ tells us again, we ought to pray and not to faint. On God's side, he's quick to hear our prayers as a plea of help from his children, as a parent is willing to rescue his child who cries out for help in danger. When should we pray? Well, especially in times of trials, of temptations. See the example of Christ in the agony in the garden, how he perseveres in his prayer with resignation to God's will. And if God doesn't free us from our trial, he may send an angel of consolation, as he did to our Lord in the Garden of Gethsemane, that we might have the grace to at least bear the cross, which sometimes, often, is a better grace than being freed from the cross. We can pray while we work. We can pray with little glances towards God throughout the day. Maybe not with our lips, but at least with our heart. When we need guidance, to turn to prayer, as the saints did, who continually shaped their lives according to lights that they received in prayer and contemplation. And so, as a result, their thoughts, their words, their deeds was all under the divine guidance of their Father. In him they lived, they moved, and they had their being. As St. Paul said. So we must be prudent in prayer. We must, secondly, watch in prayer. This is to say, we must live as we pray. Prayer is not something merely of a different world, abstract, but something practical. It has an effect upon our life. So we should strive that our behavior be consistent with our prayers. If we prayed our words sincerely, we would be most watchful and careful to do God's will in everything. Yet we see our sad experience that we sometimes do directly the opposite of his will after praying well, after gaining the grace of devotion. We may give even a bad example to others. Or if our prayers are not answered, we quickly become discouraged to think that God does not listen to our prayers. We ought to humble ourselves, trusting ourselves to the divine providence, to wait for his instruction, his sign of providence to lead us, and then to accept whatever he sends. In prayer, we can pray for our enemies. We can consider how much God has forgiven us. St. Teresa prayed very well when she began thinking of her faults, a way to put herself in the disposition to be open to God's grace with his humility. And so we must be prudent and pray always, to watch that our conduct does not frustrate the benefits and the graces that we pray for. So be prudent and watch in prayer. It is an art of arts to be able to behave before the throne of God as we ought. It is a certain courtesy, a certain respect, a certain love, a tenderness, not the familiarity of the modern world which tries us to put us on the equal level of God, to sit beside God. But if we humble ourselves very well to turn to our Lord with a childlike confidence, He often extends His hands and lifts us up to a surprising familiarity with God. Well, let us love prayer. It is something which, when it is frequent, it is loved. When it is rare, it is not appreciated, and we don't acquire the taste. The more that one prays, the more that one wants to pray, the more that one has a sense of God. And so let us seek to have this gift of prayer, as Our Lady did, who prayed without ceasing to God and for all of us, for all good intentions, that she has an unlimited love, practically, which showed itself by her constant union with God. Well, may we be prudent then, watch in prayer, that we may obtain the fruit of our prayers in heaven. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you. Dominus Vobiscum.
Thank you.
Yeah.
book to protect the public.
Oh.
to many others.
Thank you.